Truth, consciousness, and beauty.
Beauty?
Yeah, sundaram. Namaste.
Namaste, friends.
We are not mirror image today on Facebook. That's what it is. We are sitting exactly the same way. This is just another example what our minds perceive and what is the truth. It's all always a little changing.
So, yeah, I know some of you thought that I was, what's that word, ambidextrous. So that could play left and right. I can't. I can just play, just about play right, let alone try and play left. Oh, my baby. I keep coming back to our time with Osho in the ashram, and this was a song from those times too. It's called Beyond the Beyond the Beyond, and it's the place where I found myself through the meditations. It's a beautiful song. All these songs that they just came to me one after the other, and
you couldn't help it.
No, I couldn't help it, and also that my friends in the ashram, they liked the songs, and so they kind of, you know, it was a connection that we all had through the music. But I love this song, Beyond the Beyond.
Beyond the beyond the beyond, that's where your love is me. In the light.
It's been a long time since we played this.
Beyond the beyond the beyond, dancing at your feet, no matter where we go, no matter where we are, no matter what we do.
Shanti Om, Om Shanti Om. I hope you've been maybe already at the second day of your mantra meditation journey, if you're doing it with inner peace today. And it's a beautiful mantra to always have up our sleeves, just like the Om mantra. Om Shanti Om is really, it's like aspirin, you know, it's like we all need it. We all need to have one in the pocket.
You know, the beautiful thing about something like Om Shanti Om is if you're with a partner and you're awake in the night and you want to chant, you can chant something, these mantras, internally. You don't actually have to wake up your partner. I've learned for myself that I can actually count 108 cycles pretty easy, just being focused and counting on my fingers, and to chant Om Shanti Om. Om Shanti Om, universal peace. What could be more essential than a simple phrase, Om Shanti Om? So, yeah, it's a beautiful mantra to always have in any circumstances. Gayatri is refined. Gayatri is like a refined soundbite, you know. It's something very, very scientific. Om Shanti Om is it actually called a seed mantra? Om Shanti Om? No.
Om is a seed mantra.
Om is a seed mantra. Om Shanti. Om Shanti Om. Okay.
So before we enter our Om meditation space, just want to dedicate today's meditation. There were quite a few requests for dedication, and three of them were actually from different people asking for their friends who were in the middle of cancer treatment or just diagnosed or just starting chemotherapy. And just want to say, I'm sure there are many more in that situation, or you know people in that situation. So especially for Sharon, Michelle and Rita and Ernest, and whoever you know who's gone through that really challenging time on top of it all, through that as well. And also another touching mail was by somebody called Leonor, who said
from somebody called Leonor
who said she's caring for her mum with Alzheimer or dementia and the difficulty of being a caregiver, and often the caregivers kind of, you know, they always come second and they have maybe sometimes the even more challenging role in that dynamic. And just so whoever's in that position of being a caregiver, especially with somebody who's got dementia, our heart goes out to you also, and let's also include that in our meditation today. And there is Steve, who is transitioning in Australia to the other side. I don't know, there was a message 2 days ago which I missed, and so he's maybe already making his way up into the light. And there's no time and space anyway, so it's all in the moment. And yeah, it's a lot today. And then there is also, it fits into our whole caring vibe today, caring healing vibe. There is, it's Nurse Week in America, and so just a big gratitude and you know, bowing down to all the nurses who work so hard and are angels. And Sandy, thanks so much for making us aware of it. And all love to all love and all gratitude to the nurses all over the world, really.
Our friend Jyoti.
Yes.
In London, Jyoti, we sending you love today for your loving care that you give so freely and so generously to everybody. You nurses are angels of the world, I'm sure. And all you caregivers. I remember we play for this beautiful organization called
The Center for Discovery.
Center for Discovery, which is in upstate New York, and we play there every year. We for the
autistic?
No, not autistic. People, but it's mainly a center that takes care of autistic children. So it's very beautiful for us to play in for all these kids and older people. It's one of the highlights, actually, to be able to share the mantras in this way. But what always touches us is that the caregivers in this facility are so grateful to us, and many of them come and say that they needed so much to feel the mantras and feel the space, the benevolence that they bring. So they work so hard. And they give so much. So today's dedication is to all caregivers across the world in this very strange time.
That's pretty much all of us, because we all give care.
We all need it, and we all give it.
Everyone in our own way, wherever it's needed, in whatever way it's needed. And maybe I don't say that now.
Okay, friends. Thank you for your photos of your temples. They're very beautiful. Some of the ones you sent through are really very, very beautiful. So shall we prepare?
27 chakra.
Yeah, 27 chakra.
And today, let's. Our suggestion is to experiment with the Aum sound again, A-U-M. And again, if you feel more comfortable with Aum or just humming, you're so welcome to do whatever is the most resonant for yourself. But if you are free to chant the sound Aum with us, which has this open ah sound at the beginning, and then the oo sound, which functions like a channel for that light to land in our bodies, you know, in our maybe belly for me, in the belly of in the heart. And the mm sound really fills up our whole body with a mantra, with a sound, with a vibration. And then comes the big breath to recharge, to be ready for the next cycle of Aum.
You can actually physically see it. It's like an openness. You can use the mudra extending your arms for the ah sound and moving into the channel, and then moving it to your body, wherever you feel that your voice is resonating in your body. Like David says, there are different places. For me, it often resonates here. So, and if you can do with your eyes closed, so you could just visualize and stay in your own interior sanctuary as you chant.
Mm.
Okay.
Mm.
So let's close our eyes and come home again, saying hello to our inner world. And beginning to slow down. Slow down our breathing. Take a deep breath.
One more with sound, just letting go.
And bringing your eyes up to the center of your forehead, behind your closed eyes, just raising your eyes to the light, your sixth chakra, always light permeating from there. And feel the light flooding through your body as you chant the mantra Om, and then the seven chakra Gayatri mantra, and then the mantra Om. And just let's sit in silence for a while. Enjoy the sound of the tambour. Spine straight, your back straight. As you breathe. Thank you.
Satya. Om Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na cicadas that were so strong in the beginning, like 2 months ago or whatever, whenever we started. They're so quiet now. Amazing how the shifts.
Did you hear the monkeys?
The monkeys got quiet too. No, that's not the monkey.
Is is a song that came to me in about 5 minutes. You might relate to it. I need a beach. I need a place in the sun, somewhere out of reach, somewhere I can run, free from this world of trouble and pain, free from a world going insane. I need a beach. I need a beach. I need a place in the shade. I'm gonna sit down and forgive myself for the mistakes that I made. Free from a world of trouble and stress, my spirit's strong but my mind's in a mess. I need a beach. It doesn't have to be in Saint-Tropez, no, I don't mind. Venice Beach down in West LA, well, that'll do me fine. Copacabana, Malibu, yeah. Any old beach will do. I just need some time to get myself straight, slow down my mind and meditate on a world full of troubles and fears, meditate on this ocean of tears. I need a beach. Take me down to Blackpool Town, South End on Sea, Ipanema, Bondi Beach, it's all the same to me. I got some good friends down in Byron Bay, yeah. They got some beaches down there, you can blow your troubles away. I just need some sand under my feet, a little rocking band playing the reggae beat. Call me a coward, call me brave, but I just gotta catch me a wave. I need a beach. Wash my spirit clean, dance alone in the moonlight waves, that kind of scene. Oh Lord, if you can hear me, please send me an ocean breeze. I need a beach. It's not really that despondent, but just came out that way. You know, the beach is a metaphor for meditation. It's not a physical, geographical thing. I'm talking about our space when we move into a space of meditation. That's the beach I'm talking about. All those other things, kind of irrelevant, you know.
Yeah, I think the beach is the only place on this planet where nobody ever, or hardly anybody ever works. You know, beaches where we all are just out of...
And we take our clothes off.
We don't achieve anything on a beach. Nobody achieves anything on a beach.
Well, suntan.
Suntan.
But it's the only place on the planet where we, you know, sit around with hardly any clothes on. It's a gathering place. We can be ourselves, and we just come to relax on the beach. And that's really the meditational space for us, you know.
No,
it's a space of being naked and acceptance of life through the blessings of our inner sanctuary.
Mm. Inner beach.
Our inner beach. Yeah.
Should call it the inner beach sessions.
Okay, beloveds.
We are.
Oh yes, Loka. But anyway, thank
yes.
you. Yes. Thank you anyway.
Thank you.
We are very grateful. We're hoping that.
What are we hoping?
We're not hoping for anything anymore.
Oh, today we would have been in Buenos Aires. Today
oh.
was the 9th of May, where we were so looking forward to being in Buenos Aires. So
oh.
big, lots of love to our Argentinian friends, especially Pravas and Francisco, if you're watching. And thank you to Oscar and Gustavo for inviting us.
And Pluto.
Oh, Pluto, but he's Chilean. But anyway,
okay.
so we come next year. Inshallah, God willing, we're there.
We play a little reggae for you, Argentina. Buenos Aires people.
No tango?
Tango.
Namaste.
Namaste.